26th of November, 1603. At dinner, Lopez asked me if I believed these heathens were worthy of the artifact's alleged power. I had to admit that the Pytetians seemed noble and industrious. However, their taut skin stretched tight over sinewy muscles and lack of shame made them more similar to beasts. "And what of our leaders in the society?" he then asked. "Should they be able to wave their perfumed and ring fingers in any direction and expect us to obey, to return and sit at their side when they beckon? Do they not treat us as inferior beings, as beasts as well?" I had no answer. What he'd said was heresy and treason, but in some way, I wondered if it wasn't the truth. These things. It's not Maya or Inca. It's high. Then I could dive. All right. Here I go. Another example of syncretic belief. This figure portrayed on the cross is not Jesus Christ, but Kukulkan. I suppose a parallel could be drawn between the two. Thank you. They carried a sacred object to a great temple. The box of Isha. What was that? First of December 1603. We've entered a cenote not far from the city and set up camp in a small alcove. Lopez has spent the evening staring into the flames, utterly ensorcelled, his dinner untouched. Twice I attempted a conversation, but his silence rebuffed me each time. He is utterly focused on this artifact. If I were a more superstitious man, I would wonder if the artifact is speaking to him directly. The soldiers keep to themselves as well. They seem anxious for battle. One of their dogs stared at me all evening, as though I were to be his next meal. Thank you. These must be the Trinity soldiers who went missing. Time to move. Should still turn. Need to rotate it myself. Thank you. This rosary has 6 decades instead of the usual 5. A very ornate example of the Brigantine version. There appears to be an engraving. Andreas Lopez. Strange warriors pursued us through the caverns. We moved quickly, too quickly for an accurate description. Most of the soldiers fell in battle. They were valiant, but outmatched and outnumbered. Eventually, Lopez, I, and a single surviving soldier reached a magnificent temple. I cannot imagine how the people managed to build such a structure so deep underground. A massive door blocked our progress. Lopez, his voice frantic and breaking, ordered Perez, the last remaining conquistador, to stand guard while we worked on the mechanism. The door began to roll open. Our celebration of success was drastically cut short by the dying screams of Perez. The sound haunts me still. Of December 1603. A strange noise woke me in the middle of the night. I found Lopez still staring at the fire, though now it was nothing but coals. I asked him if he'd heard the noise as well, but all he did was grunt. I wrapped a blanket about his shoulders and built up the fire again. Then I sat and listened. Far off shrieks and hisses, likely distorted by the twists of the caverns. But underneath all those sounds, I heard a faint thrum. I've heard something like that before, but rarely, and only when in the deepest of prayers. It sounded like the voice of God. box could be here. Ishel and Shackshell protecting the box. Get the water flowing to the wheel. have to get the water flowing to the wheel.
Yes.
the water flowing to the wheel. Have to get the water flowing to the wheel.
Thank you.
destined to be alone. These figures, they look like those creatures, but they're graceful. Yashil, goddesses of protection. The silver box of Ishel was forged in paradise and brought to earth. Did those creatures make the box? Neither false gods nor zealots shall be allowed to pass. They're protecting it. Is that why they fought me so viciously? Here they keep the box until the sun's renewal. Here. It has to be here. Eclipse and a heron, like the tattoos on Onuratu's arm. But where's the box?
Thank you.
can use these to climb out of here.